Well, let me tell you the latest. We had a guest, Ken Mercer, Texas Board of Education, on last night on television, and we talked a little bit about this new AP history course. This is for college credits, and the history course is quite amazing. It's
a really good one.
Oh, no, it's a really,
it's
good,
a really good one.
This fall, over 450,000 high school sophomores and juniors, including at least 46,000 from Texas, will enroll in APUSH. 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 This is the AP history course. Now, we have always had, for the AP courses, we've always had, I think it's 1 to 5 page document that just says, hey, these are the things that, you know, have to be studied. The guy who designed Common Core is now doing the standards for all of
the SATs.
SATs, all the college exams. So if you want to get your kids into college, you have to have these. So states that say, well, I'm not going to do Common Core, like Texas, like Oklahoma. Is Ohio on that yet? All these states that are saying, I'm not going to do Common Core, you're now going to have to do it anyway because the college exams are only testing Common Core questions. Mm-hmm. Here is, there's 98 pages now. We've gone from 5 page to 98 pages. Here is the framework. And by the way, when they put this together, everybody had to sign a document of secrecy, so no one who was putting this together could leak anything to the press. I mean, this is all being done in the cover of darkness. It is so insidious. These are the things in the history framework. On the American Revolution, up to 1787 and the Constitutional Convention, almost every founding father has been omitted. There is no mention of John Adams, George Mason. There is no mention of...
I don't think they talk about Madison or Jefferson.
They don't talk about Madison. They don't talk about Jefferson. How do you talk about the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution without Madison or Jefferson? How do you do that? There is no talk about Ben Franklin. There is no talk about George Washington except one. Only his farewell address. So that means all of the battles of George Washington, all of the crossing of the Delaware, everything, none of that is on a test. So none of that will be taught.
Interesting way to go about talking about the founding of the country without the founders.
It really
is.
It's
interesting.
It? Yeah. I don't know how you do it.
Yeah,
I don't know how you do it. So all they're talking about on George Washington, the only thing that will be tested on George Washington is how the two-party system is bad from his farewell address. Hmm. Now, you go on to the Civil War. This is now what your these are your college classes, your AP history classes. The lessons on the Civil War now will not include the Lincoln-Douglas debates. It will not include the Gettysburg Address. It will not include the assassination of President Lincoln. It will not include the crucial battles, key commanders, or the valor of the common soldier. How do you tell the Civil War story without the Gettysburg Address? How do you tell the Civil War story without Grant? How do you tell the Civil War story without the second inaugural address and the death of Abraham Lincoln? How do you, what kind of imbeciles are we raising? The lessons on World War II, this is remarkable. The lessons on World War II are no longer going to be allow you to talk about the Greatest Generation. There will be no testing, no teaching of Truman, no teaching of D-Day, no teaching. The name Adolf Hitler does not make it into the test of World War II. Adolf Hitler.
Well, he played such a small role.
The Battle of Midway, the Battle of the Bulge. Every military commander, including Dwight D. Eisenhower, is omitted from the test. If you're not going to talk about Hitler, how could you possibly talk about the Nazi atrocities? The concentration camps and the Nazi atrocities are no longer being tested. However, it does this section concludes by saying this will be on the test, the dropping of the bombs on Japan. Quote, the decision to drop the atomic bomb has raised questions about American values, end quote.
Well, of course it did, when there was no reason to go to war.
Of course.
I mean, we're just indiscriminately dropping bombs on Japan for no apparent reason.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.